Hello friends, hi, hope you all are doing good. In this particular module from May 2019 as well as for November 2019 students, I'm going to cover the topic of capital gain taxation. So the way I'm going to take this module is that important provisions as well as the flow pertaining to the sections of capital gains, like what is the capital asset, what is transfer, when it is that capital gains are triggered, that is a transfer of capital asset under section 45, which is the charging section. What is short-term capital asset? What is long-term capital asset? What is capital gains on short-term capital asset and long-term capital asset? What all other circumstances which are not transfer within the definition in the Income Tax Act under section 47? What all are the consequences if that condition for transfer have been breached, which is section 47A. What happens when you do buyback of shares, which is under section 46A. Till date, if there was a buyback of listed securities, it was not taxable. But now onwards, even taxability of the listed securities is taxable and they are not exempt anymore. But how is it that the mechanism will be governed? Like if there is a buyback and the buyback is of unlisted securities, you need to pay buyback distribution tax, and thereby this particular capital gains are not taxable. But the buyback distribution tax is not applicable on listed shares, and hence section 46A will still have an interplay. But how is it that we are going to make that taxability will be a question. Then going forward, what all are the way in which you determine the cost of acquisition when a particular transfer has taken place, but this transfer is not regarded as transfer for the purpose of levy of capital gain? Like if you fall within the exemption criteria of section 47 and there is no capital gain event which is taking place, and you get a new asset, or you get a new asset from your predecessor, in that case, what should be the cost of acquisition of the capital asset which you have acquired? Then how to do the indexation? These are some of the preliminary understanding which I'm going to go through. My friends, please make sure that this is not going to be a complete code in itself. You have to make a double reading of this. You have to make your own reading. What I'm my flow will be that I am just going to give you a brief understanding of these things. You need to make your own homework after going through this. And once you have also done your homework, you can again come to this video so that you are done with your revision at three times while you are making the first reading itself. My friends, without wasting much of your time, I would now like to jump to the topic itself. Besides, just one more important thing. Considering that the amendments form a critical point of your examination, there has been one big amendment which has taken place in the taxability of capital gains. Example, the listed shares. If there was a long-term capital gain on shares which are listed on a recognized stock exchange, on which securities transaction tax was paid at the time of acquisition and at the time of sale, there was no capital gain tax and it used to be an exempted. And this exemption was not under section 47 but under section 10. That is, your income on long-term capital gains on sale of listed securities used to be exempted. But the government has brought in the amendments by which there is no more exemption to the shares of the listed securities on a recognized stock exchange. Now, if the government has decided that they want to tax this particular income not from a retrospective effect but from a prospective effect, hence it is critical for government to determine that if I am giving the grandfathering benefit, I should give you cost as on 31st January 2018. So there is a new provision, section 55, subsection 2, clause AC. There is new section 112A, which is introduced in the Income Tax Act. This is something on which I will be focusing on. And for the other aspect, I will also be focusing on illustration, but giving you the background understanding, this is something which I will be doing on a fast track mode. Friends, let us now come on the first aspect as to what is the capital asset. The crux of capital gain is on the capital asset, right? So it is necessary as to what is the capital asset. Section 2, which is definition, clause 14 or subsection 14, which says capital asset is the property of any kind held by an SSE, whether or not connected with his business or profession. Okay? Besides, there was a new clause which was introduced by Finance Act 2014, includes any security held by a foreign institutional investor which is invested in such circumstances as per SEBI regulations. Uska matlab, first of all, the capital asset is property of any kind. So my stock in trade could also be a property of any kind. And hence it was necessary for government to exclude some of the things from the definition of capital asset. And hence they have said that, see, stock in trade is not a capital asset. Okay? Like raw material or your closing stock, all these are not a capital, is not a capital asset. Then they said that personal effect is not a capital asset. Example, there are some variables. Is my shirt a capital asset? The answer is no. So the personal effect or something which has a personal effect does not have any, does not fall within the definition of capital asset. My friends, do you consider that agriculture in India should be given the utmost priority? So the rural agricultural land is also not a capital asset. In the capital asset, you will also find that what is the definition of what all falls within the rural agricultural land. So there is even specific definition assigned to it. Besides, some of the bonds, gold bearer bonds, for which the government wanted to give a renewed incentive in 1975 and 1980s. So there are certain categories of bond, 6% gold bond, 7% gold bond, 1977, 1988, 1991. All these particular deposits as well as which are backed by the government are also excluded from the definition of capital asset. My friends, when I touched upon the question of personal effect, I would also want to say that my house is also my residential house. So there should also be considered as personal effect. The jewelry which my mom wears is also a personal effect because she wears it on a regular basis. So it should also be excluded. However, it still has an inherent capacity, or it has something which is very precious, right? So it still falls within the definition of capital asset. And hence, while they wanted to keep the personal effect out from the ambit of capital asset, there were certain assets which they still wanted to cover. So they have even excluded some of the assets from the ambit of personal effect. So if there is a jewelry, or if there is an archaeological collections, there is some sort of drawings, some sort of painting and cultures, any work of art, all this is also excluded from the definition of personal effect. So this all are something which falls within the capital asset. Now the second question is, if it is a capital asset, is it a short-term capital asset or a long-term capital asset? So answer to this depends upon which is the type of asset. The second question will be, what is the period of time for which they are held by you? Depending upon all these two answers, you will come to know whether the asset is a capital asset, is a short-term capital asset or a long-term capital asset. So the largely the definition is within section 2, subsection 42A, where the period of holding is that period of holding of capital asset should be 36 months or less for it to be considered as short-term capital asset. However, there are certain exceptions carved out to it. If it is a shares of the company, okay, if it is a shares of a company which is listed on a recognized stock exchange, if it is a units of mutual, unit of a mutual fund or a unit trust of India, in all such circumstances, your period of holding will be 24 months, will be 12 months. Generally, it is 36 months. If it is listed on stock exchange, it is 12 months. If it is an equity share of a company which is not listed on a stock exchange, okay? Or let's say if it is a land and building or both, then the period of holding in that case will be 24 months. So if it is a security other than units listed on a recognized stock exchange, it is a units of recognized mutual fund, or it is a unit of unit trust of India or zero coupon bond, the period of holding will be short term, considered as 12 months or less to be considered it to be a short term capital asset. It should be 24 months or less to be considered as short term capital asset if the asset is unlisted shares or land and building or both. And if it should be held for 36% or less months for any other capital asset like units of debt oriented fund, unlisted securities or any other capital asset, then it will be considered short-term capital asset if it is held for less than 6 months. Going further, as I told you, this is the period of holding. Now, my friends, let us consider the example as to how is it that you get a capital asset. You can get a capital asset under different circumstances and in a different manner. You can get a capital asset by purchase. You can get a capital asset by way of gift. You can get a particular capital asset in the case of amalgamation or demerger of a company. In case of amalgamation or demerger of company, if there are shareholders, the shareholders will receive shares of the new company, right? And if it is the new company, then this new company will receive the capital asset which is transferred. There could be a partition of an HUF. There are so many manners in which one could receive new shares. So if all these other circumstances or all these categories are not considered as transfer for the purpose of levy of capital gains, then the answer, general answer to this, is that the period or the general understanding which anyone has is that the original period for which the original asset were held should also be included in the period of holding. So yes, my friends, over here again, there are explanation to section 2, subsection 42A, which is about the short-term capital asset. And in the explanation, the legislator have introduced the various manner in which the capital asset is received and whose period of holding should also be a widened period of holding and not just a limited period of holding. So I'll try to go and I'll try to cover the 16 odd topics which are mentioned over here. All of them are not important from your examination perspective, though some may be important from practical perspective, that too on a limited period of time. But the core focus which I'll try to make is only on something which is important from your examination perspective. So where the shares held in the company in liquidation, the period subsequent to the date of liquidation of company shall be excluded. Okay. Where the capital asset becomes the property of an SSE by virtue of section 49(1), that is in case of gift, in case of partition of an HUF, in case of inheritance, if you have received the property, then the period of which the capital asset was held by the previous owner shall be included. जब आपको पहले किसी के पास से वो मिला और उसको ये हाथ में taxable नहीं हुआ था, तो जो पहले period जो था, वो भी आपको include करना चाहिए. Then where the inventory of business is converted into or treated as capital asset by the SSE. My friends, please mark this as important because this is something which is introduced by this Finance Act. And when there is an amendment which has taken place, it is very critical for you to have a complete look of this particular aspect and go through it thoroughly. So when inventory of a business is converted into or treated as capital asset by an SSE, the period from the date of conversion or treatment as capital asset shall be considered. Pehle, ye jo amendment aaya, uske pehle, there was a situation which was covered within the legislature or within the act. That is, jab aapke paas ek capital asset tha aur aapne usko stock in trade mein convert kiya, to aapka period of holding of the capital asset will be till the date till which it is converted, right? बट उसका टैक्सेबिलिटी तब नहीं होता जब आप कन्वर्ट करते हो. उसका टैक्सेबिलिटी तभी होगा जब आपके पास कैश आएगा. आपके पास कैश कब आएगा? जब आपने जो स्टॉक इन ट्रेड को कन्वर्ट किया है, जो आपने कैपिटल एसेट को स्टॉक इन ट्रेड में कन्वर्ट किया है, व्हेन दैट यू सेल इन द ओपन मार्केट, एट दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम देयर शैल बी अ टैक्सेबिलिटी. बट दिस वॉज अ सिचुएशन विच वॉज नॉट कवर्ड, विच हैज नॉट कैप्चर्ड द अटेंशन ऑफ लेजिस्लेटर, विच लेटली कैप्चर्ड एंड नाउ दे हैव इंट्रोड्यूस्ड दैट व्हेन your stock in trade is converted into a capital asset and when you sell this capital asset, tab aapko capital gain ke liye period of holding kya hona chahiye, the date on which you intermediary date on which it is converted till the date on which the particular capital asset is sold. Now where the shares in the Indian company, which is amalgamated company, becomes the property of an SSE in lieu of the shares held in the amalgamating company. Jab amalgamation hota hai tab aapko jo naye company ka shares milta hai. So the period of for which the shares are held by the SSE in the amalgamating company shall also be included. So ye cheez yaad rakho, jab purana tha aur purana abhi bhi hai, tab purana ka cost aur period of holding rahega. Yes, period of holding, when you get a new asset in lieu of something which was of old asset, then that particular period of holding of the old asset and the cost of the old asset shall be traveling with you. This is not a basic rule, but this is something which you just need to remember or keep in your mind as a fundamental principle. Though this can be challenged by the income tax authorities when you put this the things in practice, but this is something from an examination perspective you have to keep in mind. Or where the shares or the security are subscribed on the basis of right to subscribe. Jab aapka jab right issue hota hai, tab the period from the date of allotment of the shares or securities shall be recognized. जब आपको राइट इश्यूज में जब शेयर मिलता है तब क्वेश्चन आएगा कि मैंने पहले एक ओरिजिनल शेयर्स था उसके बेसिस पे अभी राइट इशू हुआ तो मेरे को पहले का पीरियड ऑफ होल्डिंग मिलना चाहिए था. तो आंसर शुड फॉर दिस शुड बी नो बिकॉज आपका राइट इशू अभी हुआ और आपको अभी राइट मिला टू सब्सक्राइब टू द एडिशनल सिक्योरिटीज. सो द पीरियड ऑन विच द एडिशनल शेयर्स विच आर इशूड ऑन राइट आर अलॉटेड टू यू द पीरियड ऑफ होल्डिंग शैल बी कैलकुलेटेड फ्रॉम दैट मोमेंट इटसेल्फ. ओके अगेन वेदर फाइनेंशियल असेट्स जब आपको बोनस शेयर्स मिलता है तो आपको क्या पुराना पीरियड ऑफ होल्डिंग मिलना चाहिए कि जिस दिन आप बोनस शेयर अलॉट हुआ वो मिलना चाहिए. जस्ट कंसिडर इट एज अ रीजनेबल बेसिस. तो आंसर इज जब आपको बोनस अलॉट हुआ तब से मिलना चाहिए क्योंकि कैपिटल एसेट कब से पैदा हुआ जब आपको बोनस एसेट मिला. अगेन जब आपका जब कंपनी का डीमर्जर हुआ और उसने एक नए कंपनी को अपने एसेट ट्रांसफ़र किए और जो शेयर होल्डर ऑफ द डीमर्ज कंपनी थे उसको एक रिजल्टिंग कंपनी मतलब जो कंपनी को अपने एसेट्स ट्रांसफ़र किए उसके शेयर्स इश्यू हुए. So in that case also, what should be the period of holding of the shares of the resulting company? Again, जो मेरे को पुराने के बदले नया मिला, so the period of holding of the old asset shall travel with me. There are this particular category of right and clearing and all recognized stock exchange, which are actually kept in the legislature to give a flavor of this corporatization which happened back in past. So considering that this is not a corporate transaction which takes place on the regular basis, it is not relevant much from your examination perspective. This is an important where the units become a property of an SSE in consideration of transfer of units in a consolidated scheme of mutual fund. आपका कोई कोई scheme होता है 3 साल का 5 साल का कभी कभी वो roll over हो जाता है 3-5 के बहुत से schemes merge होकर एक नई scheme बन जाती है. तो फिर आपको जो नए स्कीम का जो मिला तो आपको जो नए स्कीम का नया यूनिट्स मिला तो द पीरियड फॉर विच द यूनिट्स इज कंसोलिडेटेड स्कीम ऑफ म्यूचुअल फंड्स वेर हेल्ड बाय द एसएससी शैल बी इंक्लूडेड. तो जो स्कीम जो कंसोलिडेट हुई नए स्कीम के साथ वो जो आपके पास ओरिजिनल था वो भी आपको मिलेगा. दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. प्रेफरेंसेस जब इक्विटी शेयर्स में कन्वर्ट होते हैं तो द पीरियड फॉर विच द प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स वॉज इंक्लूडेड शुड बी इंक्लूडेड. आंसर इज येस बिकॉज अगेन देर वॉज द सेम शेयर्स विच वेर हेल्ड बाई यू जस्ट देर वॉज अ डिफरेंट राइट अटैच टू दैट शेयर्स एंड नाउ दैट असेट इज डिजॉल्व एंड यू हैव रिसीविंग अ न्यू असेट फॉर दैट. सो द कॉस्ट एज वेल एज द पीरियड ऑफ होल्डिंग ऑफ द ओल्ड असेट और ऑफ द प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स ट्रैवल. Again, let us now take some rule to this. There are certain situation, जब आप देखोगे section 47 के अंदर, it covers a wide variety of things. Okay, जब debentures convert होता है, जब LLP के अंदर company gets converted into LLP, or there are more other such situations which are covered under 47. That is to give to consider certain transfers as a tax neutral transfer, but the cost of acquisition for each and every one of them is not mentioned under section, or the period of holding of each and every one is not mentioned in the section 2 subsection 42A. But in section 2 subsection 42A it is also mentioned that government will determine cost, will frame rules to determine cost in certain modes. When your debentures are converted into equity shares or any other debentures, okay, in that situation also is covered under the transition which is not regarded as transfer for the purpose of levy of capital gains under section 47. But uska period of holding ka apne dekha bhi nahi hai, to fir uske liye aapka fir se jo period of holding riya hai wo rules ke andar diya hai aur rules ke andar likha hai, see, there shall be included the period for which the bond, debentures, debenture stock as the case may be were held by the SSE prior to the conversion. मतलब जब ऐसा स्कीम आएगा तब आपके जब आपको CCDs वरना ऑप्शनली कन्वर्टेबल डिबेंचर्स के बदले इक्विटी शेयर मिला तो आपको जो ओरिजिनल आपने जितने टाइम के लिए वो डिबेंचर्स होल्ड किया था उसका भी पीरियड आपके पीरियड ऑफ होल्डिंग में इंक्लूड किया जाएगा. देर इज वन मोर थिंग इन 2016 विच केम इन टू प्लेस माई फ्रेंड्स. You will remember that in 2016 there were various scheme of disclosure of fixed assets, disclosure of income. So in that time, if somebody discloses that they have any immovable property with them, and there are records to suggest that the immovable property was held by them, and if he says that this is an immovable property, if he had disclosed, an SSE had disclosed in the income disclosure scheme in 2016 that this is a particular property which he has acquired in a particular year, for which he also has a documentation, that is, he has a stamp duty authority documentation or something, then the period of holding of such immovable property which is now disclosing under the IDS will be the period from which the original property was actually acquired. But it is only in the case of immovable property. Agar isko chhod ke dusra koi property hoga, varna immovable property hoga jiske liye aap recognize nahi kar sakte ki property kab acquired ki thi. तो वो पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन के अंदर द डेट फॉर विच यू हैव द पीरियड ऑफ होल्डिंग विल बी कैलकुलेटेड फ्रॉम फर्स्ट डे ऑफ जून 2016. ओके, नाउ मूविंग फर्दर वी विल नीड टू रिकॉग्नाइज एज टू व्हाट इज द मीनिंग. व्हाट वी सॉ करंटली इज दैट व्हाट इज कैपिटल एसेट, व्हाट इज शॉर्ट टर्म कैपिटल एसेट. जो शॉर्ट टर्म कैपिटल एसेट नहीं अगर हुआ तो वो लॉन्ग टर्म कैपिटल एसेट रहेगा. बट नाउ the important limb is what is transfer. Transfer is also defined under section 2 subsection 47. और जब ये वो लोग ने definition दिया है for clause 47 के अंदर, वो लोग ने provide किया है what is the definition of transfer. और ये transfer के definition is inclusive definition. उसका मतलब it is said that transfer in relation to a capital asset includes the following type of transaction. क्या आपको लगता है मैं कुछ सेल करता हूँ कैपिटल एसेट तो वो होना चाहिए? यस. आपको लगता है कि मैं एक कैपिटल एसेट के बदले दूसरा कैपिटल एसेट दे रहा हूँ तो वो भी ट्रांसफर के अंदर के इंक्लूडेड होना चाहिए? यस. अगर मैं कोई एसेट रिलिंक्विश कर रहा हूँ, मैं अगर कोई एसेट मेरा रिलिंक्विशमेंट ऑफ एसेट हो रहा है देन ऑल्सो इट इज़ अ ट्रांसफर. मेरा एक एसेट है उसके अंदर एक राइट्स है, अगर मैं वो मेरा राइट्स फोगो कर रहा हूँ, मेरा एक्सटिंग्विशमेंट ऑफ राइट हो रहा है then that also is transfer. उसका मतलब let's say I have a equity share of a company, if you are now trying to dilute some of my what we say, if you are trying to dilute some of my rights in the particular asset, then also it should be considered as transfer. That will be extinguishment of any rights therein. Then you know that government, if they want to make a road, they will make a compulsory acquisition of the property. So in case if there is a compulsory acquisition under any law, so that particular compulsory acquisition, it is not your voluntarily act but it is the act of government. So question is, maine transfer nahi kiya, dusron ne le liya. So the answer government which gave in terms of income tax act is that even agar koi le liya, compulsory acquisition agar hua kisi law ke tahat, will also be considered as transfer. Then the owner of capital asset may convert the same into a stock in trade of the business carried on by him. Such conversion is treated as transfer. जो conversion होता है in the stock in trade का, तब वो particular चीज़ भी transfer गिना गया है. The maturity of redemption of zero coupon bond. जब zero coupon bond को आप redeem करते हो या तो mature करते हो, तब also उसको गिना जाएगा, it will be considered as transfer. The possession of immovable property in consideration of part performance of contract referred to in section 53A. The transaction which have a effect of transferring or enabling the enjoyment of immovable property. So these two are something which also you need to consider. Ki there are certain things in which I did a contractor work, theek hai, or for which I have received an immovable property. So this possession of immovable property in part performance of कॉन्ट्रैक्ट रिफर्ड टू इन 53A ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी एक्ट इज ऑल्सो अ ट्रांसफर. तो आपने मेरा कुछ काम कर दिया, मैंने मेरे को आपका घर दे दिया, सो आपने मेरे को जो काम किया उसके लिए मैंने आपका घर, मेरा घर दे दिया, इट इज ऑल्सो ट्रांसफर फॉर मी. दिस इज वॉट देर वॉज ट्रांसफर. नाउ एवरी थिंग इन द एक्ट हैज अ चार्जिंग सेक्शन. income from house property has a charging section, income from business and profession has a charging section, even income from other sources has a charging section. Likewise, in the capital gain provision, section 45 is a charging section. Section 45 provides that what should be, when is it that the charge of the capital gain arises, and which is the year in which it will be considered as chargeable to the capital gains. So there is section 45(1). Any profit and gains arising on transfer, the definition of which we see now, which we saw now, that of a capital asset, whose definition we saw later, in a previous year, shall be chargeable to income tax under the head in the previous year in which the transfer took place. जिस साल में ट्रांसफर होता है उस पर्टिकुलर साल के अंदर आपकी टैक्सेबिलिटी अराइज होगी. नाउ देर आर सर्टन सिचुएशन इन विच यू विल कंसिडर दैट अरे इट इज़ डिफिकल्ट फॉर बिकॉज आई एम सेइंग दैट इट इज चार्जेबल इन दिस ईयर बट दो आई एम सेइंग इट इज़ अगेन अ कैपिटल ट्रांसफर दो आई एम सेइंग दैट इट इज़ अ ट्रांसफर ऑफ कैपिटल असेट बट देर आर सर्टन सिचुएशन इन विच यू विल नॉट रिसीव कैश इन द ईयर इन विच यू आर ट्रांसफरिंग बट यू विल रिसीव इट इन लेटर इन सम फ्यूचर डेट. So it will create an unnecessary or an unfair leeway on the particular SSE because he has not received cash. How will he discharge his income tax obligation? So the government has thought or kept the mechanics that in some of the specific situation, I will defer the income tax liability on a future date when the particular cash is received by him. So what all are the situations and what all are the provisions are now to come? So let's take from an example, see there is an insurance parties where a person receives any money or a capital asset under any insurance from any insurer on account of damage hua, ya to koi cheez destruction hua, kabhi flood aaya ya to typhoon hua, ya to maine koi cheez ka insurance liya tha and that particular insurance, that particular asset is not in good shape for now because of any attack from an enemy. Then the taxability will be the previous year in which the money or the capital asset was received. मतलब भले आज damage हुआ but मेरे को एक साल के बाद पैसा मिला तो मेरे को वो एक साल के बाद when I receive a money or any other capital asset in that particular year I will be subjected to tax. और ये insurance कैसे relevant होता है और insurance के अंदर आपका जब capital asset चला जाता है then it particularly falls within the extinguishment of asset. सुबह को देखा एसेट था रात को अर्थवेक आया और सुबह को दूसरे दिन सुबह को एसेट नहीं था. इट इज़ एन एक्सटिंग्विशमेंट ऑफ एसेट रेलिंक्विशमेंट ऑफ एन एसेट. तो ये जब रेलिंक्विशमेंट ऑफ एन एसेट होता है तब आपको जो कैश मिला इंश्योरेंस के अंदर और दूसरा कोई कैपिटल एसेट मिला इंश्योरेंस के अंदर इट विल बी सब्जेक्टेड टू द ईयर इन विच दिस कैश और विच दिस न्यू कैपिटल एसेट इज रिसीव्ड. अगेन देर इज इंपॉर्टेंट एलिमेंट विच अराइज इन द कन्वर्जन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ कैपिटल एसेट एज स्टॉक इन ट्रेड. पहले मैंने जब बताया था आपको बोला कि ये नया प्रोविजन है वो किसके लिए था याद करो इट वाज फॉर स्टॉक इन ट्रेड इनटू कैपिटल असेट. बट मैंने बोला कि सेक्शन कैपिटल असेट इनटू स्टॉक इन ट्रेड ऑलरेडी कवर था बट वो कवर कहाँ पे था सेक्शन 45 सब सेक्शन 2 के अंदर. तो वो लोग ने बोला ठीक है आज के दिन आपके पास लैंड है आपने उसके ऊपर बिल्डिंग बना दिया आपके आज आपके पास आप वरना आपने उसको स्टॉक इन ट्रेड बना दिया बट आज आपने सेल नहीं किया आज आपके पास कैश नहीं है आपके पास कैश कब आएगा जब आप उसको बेचोगे तो आपका कैपिटल गेन मैं आज के दिन ट्रिगर हो जाएगा. कैपिटल गेन्स मैं आज के दिन के हिसाब से बेचूंगा बट आपको मैं टैक्स कब लगाऊंगा आपको मैं चार्ज कब करूंगा जब आपके पास कैश आएगा. ठीक है. सो एज पर नॉट विथस्टैंडिंग एनीथिंग कंटेंट इन सेक्शन 45(1) बीइंग द चार्जिंग सेक्शन द प्रॉफिट अराइजिंग फ्रॉम कन्वर्जन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट चार्जेबल टू इनकम टैक्स एज इनकम ऑफ द प्रीवियस ईयर इन विच द स्टॉक इन ट्रेड इज सोल्ड और अदरवाइज ट्रांसफर्ड बाई हिम. ठीक है. सो ये देखो दैन जब मैं आज के दिन वो मेरा कैपिटल असेट है बाद में वो मेरा स्टॉक इन ट्रेड हुआ बाद में मैंने स्टॉक इन ट्रेड बेचा देर विल बी टू इवेंट्स विच विल बी ट्रिकरिंग. एक तो मैंने मेरा स्टॉक इन ट्रेड बेचा उसके लिए मेरे को जो प्रॉफिट आएगा ऑन दैट सेल शैल बी कंसिडर्ड एज बिजनेस इनकम. एक तो मैंने मेरा एसेट कैपिटल असेट बेचा जिसके ऊपर जो मेरी कैपिटल गेन टैक्स लाइबिलिटी अराइज थी वो मेरे को फिर से भरनी पड़ेगी. So the cost of asset will be the original cost which I had it. Now the full value of consideration for the purpose of charging the capital gains will be the fair market value on the date in which the conversion took place. ये हो जाएगा मेरा capital asset. तो मैंने इनका कैपिटल गेन टैक्स किस पे लगाया, मैंने लगाया फेयर मार्केट वैल्यू पे ऑफ द डेट इन विच द कन्वर्जन टुक प्लेस, तब मेरे को उसका कॉस्ट भी मिलना चाहिए ना। तो कल उठ के जब मैं मेरा स्टॉक इन ट्रेड बेचूंगा तब ये जो फेयर मार्केट वैल्यू था ऑफ द कैपिटल असेट था ना, दैट विल बिकम नाउ कॉस्ट। और जब मैं वो जब मैं मेरा ये पर्टिकुलर स्टॉक इन ट्रेड सेल करूंगा एट दैट पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम, जो भाव पे मैंने बेचा दैट विल बी अ सेल प्राइस माइनस द FMV of the capital asset on which I had paid the capital gain tax will be considered as my cost of acquisition of that particular stock in trade. Again, when there is a transfer of beneficial interest in any securities, again agar koi ek transfer ho raha hai of a capital of the कोई सिक्योरिटीज़ के अंदर आपका जो इंटरेस्ट है दैट इज़ ट्रांसफर्ड, दैट इज़ ऑल्सो सिचुएशन विच इज़ कवर्ड विद इन द इनकम टैक्स एक्ट। मूविंग फर्दर वी ऑल्सो हैव अ सिचुएशन वेयर लेट्स से पार्टनर ऑफ एन एच यू लेट्स से अ पार्टनर ऑफ अ फर्म और अ मेंबर ऑफ एन एसोसिएशन ऑफ पर्सन और BOI बॉडी ऑफ इंडिविजुअल वॉन्ट्स टू set a particular BOI or a firm or wants to introduce a capital asset where he is already a partner or a member. In this particular case also, when this is will be an event will be considered as transfer, and the full value of consideration for the transferor will be considered as the value at which the particular firm or the particular AOP or BOI records in the books of account the value of that asset. That particular value will be considered as full value of consideration for the purpose of transfer in this case where there is an introduction of assets. This is under section 45 subsection 3. Now there is one more section, section 45 subsection 4. So this the earlier case was that when you are introducing to a firm or an EOP or a BOI, but now the firm is distributing it on dissolution. Distribution of the capital asset on dissolution of association of person, BOI or the firm, that is section 45 subsection 4. Then the distribution which says that on distribution of capital asset on dissolution of firm or AOP or BOI or otherwise. There are some controversies about or otherwise which we will discuss. But in this case again, what should be the full value of consideration when the company, when this firm is dissolving its asset, transferring its asset on dissolution? So the answer to this is again the full value of consideration will be fair market value of the assets distributed. Now the question arises, this is the distribution of capital asset on dissolution of firm or BOI or AOP or BOI or otherwise. So the question is whether otherwise will also apply when the firm is in continuance, or it has to be read as adjustum generis with the word distribution. So there is one famous landmark judgment of the Bombay High Court in the A.N. Naik case, in which it is said that otherwise has not to be read in the adjustum generis with the expression distribution of the firm, individual or association person. The term otherwise has to be read with the word transfer of a capital asset by distribution of capital asset. Okay, so when there is a transfer of capital asset as a distribution of capital asset, even when the firm is itself in existence, there shall also be a levy of a capital gain tax in that particular moment itself. The word otherwise takes its sweep not only cases of dissolution but also the cases of subsisting partners of the partnership transferring assets in favor of retiring partner. उस मतलब जब retiring partner होगा, जब partner को retire किया जाएगा, तभी भी 45(4) apply होगा. मैंने आपको थोड़े टाइम पहले बताया कि कंपलसरी एक्विजिशन भी 45 के अंदर कंपलसरी एक्विजिशन भी ट्रांसफ़र के अंदर डेफिनेशन के अंदर आता है. तो जब गवर्नमेंट मेरा कंपलसरी लैंड एक्वायर करता है, आपको तो पता है गवर्नमेंट धीरे धीरे से पैसा देगा, सो इट विल बी टैक्सेबल इन द ईयर इन विच यू रिसीव द कैश. ओके, अगेन इफ देयर इज एन एनहेंस्ड कंपनसेशन, सो द एनहेंस्ड कंपनसेशन व्हेन अ पर्सन हैज़ टेकन ओवर बाय सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, the compensation from the government go to court of law offer enhancement of the compensation. If the court awards the compensation whichever is higher than the original compensation, the difference will be chargeable in the year in which the same is received from the government. राइट, जब आपको 100 रुपये के बदले 200 मिलने वाले थे, तो जो एडिशनल 100 रुपीज़ होगा इट विल बी रिसीव्ड व्हेन यू हैव रिसीव्ड द फाइनल ऑर्डर एंड यू हैव रिसीव्ड द कंपेंसेशन एज वेल. Today there is some situation in major cities like Mumbai, Delhi and all. If you have a plot of capital, if you have a plot of land and if somebody wants to develop, so the builder is not getting any land. So what do they do is they enter into a development agreement. In the development agreement they say that okay, there will be a in future you will receive a specified sum out of it, you will receive 2 or 3 floors of this in future when the